Vestal. Chapter 1. Want not. Together with her sisters, she tended the Order's sacred flame in pious humility. The Abbey's austere arches and sanctified masonry afforded her a life of sheltered privilege that few beyond the walls could imagine. Discipline was paramount, and when forbidden desires would seek to distract her from monastic toil, she smothered them. Reluctantly. Chapter 2, A Momentary Lapse. She was a paragon of duty and virtue, but reminders of her deprivation were everywhere. Surely she deserved some indulgence for her labors. Immersed in her reverie, she started violently at the piercing admonitions of the furious abbot. Chapter 3, No God But Men. Her terrified wails rang off the transepts as the abbot dragged her to the oubliette. As a deterrent to the congregation, her punishment would be more than commensurate with her blasphemy. Locked interminably in the festering dark, she awaited retribution from the divine, while suffering the mortal tortures of its enraged servants. Chapter 4, Divine Intervention. Vindication. A golden ray beamed affirmation into the stagnant blackness of the dungeon. No divine punishment awaited her. It was her captors who had strayed from the light.
Thank you.
radiant with revelation, she stormed the stairs to the cloisters. Chapter 5, Wrath. Eager to share her emancipation with her convent, she rushed headlong toward the dormitory, but where the chamber door once stood, she was met instead by a sheer wall of fresh masonry. Her cries of jubilation died in her throat. From behind the drying mortar and sturdy stone, there came a feeble scratching. Then her sister's last hideous gasps. The price of her wantonness would not be measured solely in blows from the flail.